How can you preach the benefits of a rolling monthly contract when you use a phone like the Samsung Galaxy S3? It doesn't make sense.
You just argued my point. I use the phone like the Samsung Galaxy S3. I use the Samsung Galaxy S3 as my main phone.
Yeah.
And I review all these other phones. I review this £50 ZTE Kiss.
Which you absolutely
which
love.
Which is a £50 smartphone at the end of the day that uses most of the apps that the Samsung Galaxy S3 can use as well, thanks to the Google Play Store. So that's 50 quid. If I want a phone off contract, I'm not going to use the Samsung Galaxy S3 to its full extent. I should well consider a cheaper phone to save me money until a phone comes out that I will actually use.
But what if you want the latest phone now? You can get it now. All you have to do is go into a long-term monthly contract.
Yeah.
Then you can have the phone you want now, like the good phones, the S3s, the iPhones. At your fingertips.
If I did that, I would be paying a monthly contract and in turn giving money away to the network provider. Ultimately, if I got the phone offline, got a £15 a month rolling contract that gave me unlimited everything, save about 50 quid at the end of the 24-month contract, and I'd still have the freedom to upgrade when I wanted to, selling off my phone. And if we're talking about the iPhone, resale value on the iPhone's amazing. So I wouldn't really be losing much money in depreciation.
Not everyone has like £600 lying around for an iPhone or an S3 to just go into a store and pick one up or get it off online. You need a contract. That's why they're there, so that people can get the latest tech on a long-term thing. So they don't have to pay, they just pay £30 a month in installments, and then they can have the latest tech now, rather than having to wait or save up in little installments. And
that's the most backward argument I've ever heard in my life. Because 6 months, 3 months
then
down the line.
Then why do contracts exist? Why do they exist?
3 months down, because people don't have enough foresight. 3 months down the line, a new phone comes out that you want even more. 6 months down the line, a year down the line, the S2 and the S3 were a year apart, but people have got an S2 on a contract, likelihood is, can't upgrade because they're tied in.
There's now schemes where you can just upgrade like every 6 months, like Jump on Phones for You. Like you can just upgrade as much as you want. You can have the latest phone and the running contract.
Yeah, but look at Jump, you end up paying a whole lot more money for upgrading because there's a huge premium associated with that. Yes, you can upgrade, but you're paying, I think it's something like £5 to £10 a month more per month just for the privilege. Whereas a little bit of foresight, a little bit of forward planning, and you could end up with a decent or a flagship phone even on a rolling contract. So a lot of people would be more than happy with something like the ZTE Grand X. It's a £200 phone, but it's got a dual core processor, ice cream sandwich on board, really, really nice device. This is for the people who don't need all the functionality of the S3, don't need the stunning camera, the slim design, all that jazz.
I'm talking about what people want. The people who want that stuff might not be able to afford it. That's why the beauty of a long-term contract works the way it does. You hang out with your friends who share that enthusiasm, and you go with your £50 ZTE or whatever, and they're there with their Galaxy S3 and their iPhone.
Yeah.
You're going to feel a little bit left out, right?
I'll feel quite smug.
Why?
I'll feel smug because I know I'm doing exactly what I need to do to get the iPhone, how and when I need to get it. If I did have a ZTE Kiss, I'd exalt the £50 price tag. I'd completely be upfront with the fact that this means I can offline get a Samsung Galaxy S3 or 4, iPhone 5, and not have to get into some crazy 24-month credit-dependent contract.
It's not that crazy. The companies understand it. Carriers are pushing it. It just makes sense. Hi guys, it's Alex here with Recombu, and today I'm going to be showing you Seedio for iOS. Now, Seedio at the moment is a free application, but it's going to go paid soon, so get it quick. What it does basically is it allows you to stream music over your local Wi-Fi network to all up to 5 other iOS devices. So if you've got some friends around, you want to play them a tune on your phone, but you don't want to use headphones for everyone, although you can stream over Seedio. So we're going to test it out with the help of my lovely assistant Basil. And basically how it works is you have the Seed interface, and with this toggle at the top, you have the Receive interface. So Basil's iPhone here is set to Receive. I'll give that to you. Now he has no music on this iPhone. I'm setting mine to Seed. And you can choose music from your music, from YouTube, from a history, and you can even clear your playlist. So I'm going to go to my music. I'm going to pick a couple of songs from my iPhone's music collection. Done. now that added to the queue. So all I need to do now, tap this button, music started playing on here, and now you can see my iPhone is on Basil's. If he taps this, the music is now playing over the Wi-Fi to his, but you can have up to 5 devices, like I said, so he should be able to hear what the speakers are playing out. You got that? Excellent. So we're gonna go outside and test how good Seedio is at keeping in sync and keeping connected. So follow me. Music's still playing here. Just go down the stairs. Great tune. Hopefully Basil likes it too. So I can still hear everything playing here. Now the question is, can Basil? He's bopping. I'm gonna stop the music and see what he does. Hey, good tune? Sorry, I stopped it. That came through with you, right? Excellent. Sorry, I just got to cut the video short. So that's Seedio. You can get it now in the App Store for free. It'll be paid soon, so pick it up quickly. Thanks.
Walk into a store with 50 quid in your pocket, well, 60 quid to be precise, and you're not going to expect to leave with a smartphone. But you can. You can leave with a ZTE Kiss, to be precise. Now, the ZTE Kiss has an 800 megahertz processor and a 3.5-inch display. That's the same size as the iPhone. Sure, it's HVGA resolution, but it's 50 quid. You'll have to get £10 Virgin top-up to get this out of the store. However, once you do, you've got full access to the Android Google Play Store, so you can access thousands and thousands of applications, movies, etc. It's got Wi-Fi, it's got a GPS on board. 50 quid, you can't get a GPS for 50 quid. Literally, we're blown away by the value of the ZTE Kiss, and that's why it's our Bake of the Week.